Hello, welcome everybody. I'm still rubbing my lotion in my hands. Welcome to another Facebook Friday for Lychee Friday. Oh my goodness, we love Fridays around here, don't we? So hopefully you guys have had a good week amongst all of kind of the craziness that is the coronavirus pandemic, right? Excuse me, I've got this frog in my throat. I'm gonna just hold off for a quick sec while people pop on and say hello. Hi, Nancy, how are you doing? I'm seeing some eyeballs popping up there. So, hey, Nikki, good morning. Kathy, nice to see you guys. Yes, good morning, good morning. So, and Nancy Gulick, hello, how are you? Hopefully you guys are all doing okay. Sheltering in your homes, right? Such a crazy time, oh my goodness. Philomena, hello, welcome, welcome. So yeah, I just wanna say, first of all, welcome to anybody new that's watching Facebook Live for the first time. I go live pretty much every Friday right here on this Facebook group at 11:30 a.m. So I'd love to have you join me. We're gonna keep doing this. I mean, it's easy for me. This is what I work from home quite a bit. So that whole, you know, staying at home hasn't maybe affected me quite as much as maybe other people that are used to going out all the time. I can stay really busy right here in my house, that is for sure. So let's see, what do I wanna tell you guys about? Just so you know, if you've never caught me live, it's funny because I'm kind of thinking about the whole live in a different perspective now. And this is kind of off topic, but so the group fitness class that I go to most every morning during the week, you know, obviously fitness, gyms, that whole stuff, all of that. I mean, even before, like, everybody was told to stay at home, gyms were told, you know, we can't, you know, you can't be open. So yeah, you've made some fun fold cards. That's awesome, Anna. Good for you. So anyway, I've learned from doing my workout videos. Hey, Kay. Well, let me back up. The gym is closed, so the gal that runs the group fitness classes has been doing Facebook Live videos for us. She set up a separate Facebook group, so anybody that's, you know, current member with her can hop on that Facebook group and basically work out at the times that we normally would go to our classes. Good morning, everybody. So as I've been doing this, I've been thinking more about, like, now I'm the watcher of Facebook Lives versus I've always been like the talker, the person doing the Facebook Lives. So it's made me realize one thing that I love. For example, normally I go to an 8:15 a.m. class, and the first morning, so Tuesday morning, I'm all ready to go. And you know, I don't do anything too much in advance, right? So I was ready at like 8:12 to start the workout, and I go on to the Facebook group, and she's already started. Well, she actually started at 8 o'clock. She's gonna be doing them at 8 o'clock instead of 8:15. Not a big deal, but what I found was interesting was then I actually went back. She does a 5 a.m. class, which I will probably never ever do, but I could go back on the group and do the 5 a.m. workouts because I didn't wanna start like in the middle of the 8:15 workout that actually started at 8 a.m. So anyway, it's really just got my mind like thinking more about like being a watcher of Facebook Lives too, and how important it is. Like, I'm always kind of directing my Facebook Lives to the people that I see watching because those are the only people that I know that are watching. So what I'm realizing is, you know, people pop on later too, clearly. I mean, we have lots of views of the video later. So I want to try to be mindful, maybe more so than I have been in the past, of that as a result of doing these videos. So anyway, I could work out all day long if I wanted to now, not that I really could, but anyway, you know, actually one day I was feeling really good. So I did like the 5 a.m. workout and then I did part of the 8:15 a.m. workout, which I would never have been able to do before, but now they're all on video. And the other cool thing is, like, tomorrow, if like normally she does a 6 a.m. workout, well, I don't know, I don't get up at 6 a.m. on Saturday, so I can get up at whatever time I get up and do her workout any time of the day. So it's been really cool. But anyway, like I said, it's just kind of gotten me to think a little bit differently about the Facebook Lives. And Nancy is saying she's trying to mail a card to a friend or two that she hasn't seen in a while, or send someone to a nursing home, and now I've got a see more button. Anyway, but I'm kind of getting the idea of Nancy's comment here is this is the perfect time. We're all stuck at home. I'm sure many of us have a fairly large stash of cards that we could jot a little note and send it off to someone, and how appreciative, even more so than ever, people are to receive a handmade card from us right now. So very good thought, Miss Nancy. So thank you for that. So, okay, let me get myself back on track. So we've been featuring... This is the Timeless, hey Becky and Susan, good morning. This is the Timeless Tulips Bundle that we have been featuring on our Facebook group all week long. Did I say bundle? It's Timeless Tulip stamp set and then the tulip punch. Thank you for sharing the video too, Becky. I appreciate that. So I want to show you, if you haven't had a chance to peek at the sentiments, because they're great. Very versatile. I always love a very versatile stamp set because we've got different sentiments on here. So first one is, may the memories of yesterday comfort you today. So that's a good one for sympathy. What a difference one single life makes. Hey, Amy Jo. There's a hello, a happy birthday, happy Easter, happy spring, happy, happy everything, a get well soon, and a happy Mother's Day. So you can see, yes, lots of different sentiments. Oh, Rosemary's saying she's not in quarantine. She's still got to work. I know for any of those essential businesses, we are still doing our thing. So thank you guys for sharing. So, and then I love all of the different tulip images that are on this stamp set. So beautiful imagery and then fabulous sentiments. And then of course the punch that coordinates with the images in the stamp set. So if you haven't joined me for Facebook Live before, we are gonna make a couple of projects with our product of the week. We're gonna do that a little bit later on in the video. To tell you from last week, our product of the week was the full amount, like what was the name of it? That was so last week I can barely remember. Hey Liz, how are you? The Full of Happiness stamp set. So I actually demonstrated these two cards last week. So anybody that put on an online order last week is going to get these projects, either fully made cards or the make and takes. They can decide if they put an online order and they get the make and takes or full cards from me as a thank you. Their name also goes into a drawing for a fabulous prize that we will draw for in just a little while. So that's the same case this week. In addition though, you guys, I'm seeing all these comments and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna come back because you guys are being awesome. I love all of your comments, but I feel like I'm gonna get so sidetracked if I comment on each of them. So please know I will go back. I'm gonna read every single comment. I truly, truly, truly appreciate your comments. I'm just afraid that this video could be 3 hours long if I comment and really get into everybody's comments. So just know that I'm not ignoring you. I love to see your comments and it's fun for me to read through them after the Facebook Live. So thank you. Keep commenting. I do appreciate that. But I feel like you guys are super commenty today, probably because we haven't had many people to talk to, right? So fabulous. It's a great, social media is an awesome way to kind of help us stay connected in these very crazy times, right? Hey, Diane. Hello. So, okay. The other thing I want to mention is too, for the projects that I'm going to demonstrate in a little while, because I think I forget to say this a lot of times. Excuse me. If you see how I did that, I kind of coughed in my wrist. I didn't really cough, right? But trying to practice, right? The social, I don't know, whatever. The good social behavior. So anyway, here I get it. I'm getting so sidetracked. It's just going to happen today, isn't it? We're all like a little loopy by now too. Okay, this was my point, was for the projects that I demonstrate, hop on over to my blog, which is Gathering Ink with a K, so gatheringinkspiration.com, after the Facebook Live video. You got to give me a little bit of time because I got to get everything uploaded, but I will have the item codes, the names of the products, everything that you need to know, colors, dimensions to make these cards or order what you need to make these cards. Okay, so just know that that'll be there this afternoon at gatheringinkspiration.com. Okay, sorry, I had some extra notes because I wanted to make sure that I told you guys everything. So, okay, yeah, too many notes. Now I'm like, whoa, why did I write so many notes to myself? Oh well, it just happens, right? So Diana, good morning, good morning. Okay, so the other big thing we have going on right now is my online, I think I called it the Sheltering in Place Online Buy One, Get One Free Sale. So if you haven't seen it yet, if you haven't checked it out yet, because Facebook was being kind of funny. So you should be able to though, like on, you know, scroll down after you watch the video, you'll see like a yellow striped banner and that's the online BOGO sale banner. whatever, if you just click on that, I'm going to try to keep posting about it here so it kind of stays at the top of this group feed so it'll be easy for you to find because people have had a little bit of trouble finding it. Anyway, just click on that banner and that will take you to, I set it up as an event on our Facebook group. So there are two different tabs, and depending, I think it probably takes you to the About tab, which is basically kind of all the, I don't know, legal mumbo jumbo about how the buy one, get one free event works. And then there's another tab. So you have to scroll down just a little bit and you'll see one tab says About and another tab says Discussion. So About tells you how the buy one, get one free works. And then the Discussion tab, sorry, this happened last week too. I feel like my throat's all like weird. I'm feeling fine and now I'm like all super self-conscious that I'm going to be clearing my throat and coughing and you guys are going to think I'm not feeling well, and I'm fine. I'm really fine. So anyway, sorry, I had to put that out there. Anyway, the Discussion tab is what you want to click on to see a picture of every single product that I have put on my buy one, get one free sale. So these are all retired products. So this is how it works. And this is kind of why I laugh, like people call it Facebook jail. I feel like I almost kind of got put in Facebook jail from the standpoint of, I think I had like I probably have like 200 items that are in the sale. So it includes stamp sets. This is all retired stuff. So nothing that you can get out of the current catalogs. So I've retired stamp sets, retired punches, retired dies and embossing folders. And then I was trying to get a bunch of like smaller price items like ribbon and embellishments. And I think I got like 160 pictures uploaded. And then Facebook was like, what are you doing? Basically, they thought I was spamming. They thought I just kept like posting pictures and I was gonna be driving everybody crazy. Hopefully I'm not. Hopefully I'm helping you guys out with this buy one, get one free sale. But basically they shut me down. I tried to post my next bolt of ribbon and they're like, lady, you gotta stop. So I tried on and off yesterday and it still wouldn't let me. I'll try again today. So most of the items are on the Discussion tab already. I will, if I can get more items uploaded. If not, there's lots and lots to shop from. But this is how, sorry, I gotta get a drink. This is how the buy one, get one free sale works online. So go to the buy one, get one free sale, click on the Discussion tab, you'll see pictures. And any picture that has a comment below it that says, I want this one, that means that person has already gotten it. And I make a comment that says, okay, or you got it or something. So you know that I saw that you want that item. And I'm going on periodically. It's not necessarily gonna happen automatically because I have to literally scroll through that whole list to see who's commented on things. Okay, but that's the first thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna go through there, you're gonna look at a stamp set or whatever it is, the price should be on there. And if you want it, you're gonna say, I want this item. And then I'll know that one's yours and I grab it out of my stash and I set it aside for you. So whatever dollar value you get to on those, I want that retired product. So say you get to $100 in retired product on the pictures. Then you go over to stampinup.com and use the host code that I gave you. It's on my blog. I'll give it to you in just a little while too, but my host code is always at gatheringinspiration.com on the right-hand side toolbar. You always see that. So you'll grab that host code, you'll shop. You'll pick $100 in product, current catalog. So you're just gonna type in your item codes, whatever you want. Put your order in, use that host code, and then I know that you've shopped. You can send me a message too. I mean, I'm checking on the Discussion tab when people comment on there. So I've been messaging people back and forth because some people are putting their online order in first and then shopping on the retired stuff. And some people are shopping from the retired stuff. And then I say, okay, this is your total. Now go shop. Or honestly, I am happy to put an order in for you too. If that's just like too much for you, I get it. It can be a pain in the butt. You can send me a message and I can put the order in for you. Okay. So you guys, this is awesome. Yeah. I'm going to read back through that, Anna. There's probably a better way to do that. Although multiple pictures. Yeah, I'll look into that. Thank you, Anna. I appreciate that suggestion. So maybe I'll have to try that next time. In the meantime, this is what we got going this time. So, but the other cool thing is, so as part of this buy one, get one free sale, so back to, say, you found $100 in retired product, you put your $100 order in online or give it to me and I'll put it in for you, you're going to get two free $50 celebration items, right? Because it's still celebration time. Plus, you're going to get the make and takes or the full completed cards that I'm going to make in a little while. Your name is also going to go into next Friday's Facebook Live drawing, and you automatically get the PDF tutorial emailed to you also. So this is an amazing time, the final moments of Sale-a-Bration, right? I wanted to make sure I mentioned that a couple of times. Sale-a-Bration is ending March 31st. Most people don't even know what day of the week it is anymore. It is Friday. So next Tuesday, March 31st at midnight Salt Lake City time, which is mountain time, that's the last time that you can take advantage of Sale-a-Bration, okay? So just know that. This is like, that's why I thought, okay, I'm gonna do this BOGO sale. First of all, because everybody's stuck at home. I'm stuck at home and I am stressing out about making my, meeting my goal for this quarter because I'm not very close yet. So do truly appreciate your orders. And then what a great deal for you guys to get BOGO stuff, you know, do a BOGO sale to get retired stuff as well for free. So if I haven't literally said that, because I feel like maybe I haven't, what you're essentially doing is you're buying current catalog product, you pay the full shipping and sales tax on that, and then you're gonna get the retired product from all those pictures on my buy one, get one free sale, you're gonna get that for free. Now, if you're local to me, I'm gonna just bag all that up, I'm gonna put orders out on my porch and I'll let you know when they're here and you can just come and pick them up. I think that's like the safest, most sanitary way to handle it is just have them all outside, let you know when they're here. If you're not local to me though, I'm gonna package everything up and I'm gonna ship it to you. So you do have to pay the shipping on that retired product also, okay? So it just depends. I'm gonna put them in priority mail. Either an envelope is like $8 and the box is like $15. So it just depends on how much you order. I'll put as much as I can in the smaller padded envelope, but I want to make sure it gets to you safely also. So the other thing I want to tell you guys, I'm going to give you my phone number. If you guys want to call or text me, if you have any questions or problems, I'm happy to help you out. I'm here. I'm working from home. I would love to, you know, help make sure you can take advantage of this awesome deal. So my phone number is, it's area code 989-330-0259. And if I'm on another call or I can't take your call, please leave me a message and I will call you back, or text me, I will text you back, okay? So, hey guys, I think Mary hopped on, and Debbie, thank you guys for hanging out with me and thank you for sharing, Debbie. So, okay, I knew I wanted to make sure to get through all of that, so I think I did. So the other quick thing I wanted to mention, because I was super embarrassed, you guys, and I sent out a message because I know I probably upset some people and I truly did not mean to. Things got super crazy. So Monday here in Michigan is when our governor said, everybody stay at home. I think the order went into effect Monday night. So what happened was I ran to my other jobs. I am an accountant also. I maybe don't ever really share that much, but I do have jobs, like part-time jobs outside of doing Stampin' Up. So I kind of like dropped everything because I don't normally go into the office on Monday. And I was like, okay, I gotta get to the office. I gotta get a bunch of stuff done, thinking, you know, I really shouldn't be leaving the house after that. So what happened was, in my furor to like get to work and get everything done that I needed to do at work, I didn't think about my email that, and just so you guys know this, so my email, you know, you see those, like I send them really regularly, right? I know, because I wanna make sure everybody's well informed. But what I do is, so at the end of the month, so I'm actually going to start prepping. So at the end of March, right now, I'm going to prep for all my email that go out in April. So actually, back at the end of February, I prepped for all my email that are going out this month in March. And the one email that went out the literal day after the governor said, stay at home until April 13th, was, hey guys, guess what? We're going to have card class on like April 8th or 10th. And I was like, oh, I'm so embarrassed that that email went out, because it just went out automatically, if you see what I mean. Like, I scheduled them back in February and I didn't even have a chance to think about, check your email and make sure nothing inappropriate is going out right now. So I apologize if I caused any, whatever the feeling might have been, like, oh my gosh, I can't believe she's still planning on having class. I'm not having class on April 8th and 10th, I think were the days originally that it was scheduled, because we're not allowed to. We're not allowed to leave our houses unless we're part of an essential business. So just so you guys know that, because I don't want anybody to be upset or worried that I'm not following the rules, because I'm trying to be really, really good about this too. So in the meantime, we're just having fun at home. But so I, again, don't want to have upset anyone with that email. It basically went out before I even realized it. And then the next day I was like, oh my gosh, that's like the worst possible email that could have gone out to everybody. So thank you, Philomena. I know most people do understand. I just wanted to make sure everybody didn't think that like I put that email together like Tuesday morning right after our governor said, no, you can't leave the house. So anyway, all right. I know you guys are all good, but I was super embarrassed. And so I thought I would make sure to kind of communicate that. So, okay. One other quick thing to mention is my PDF store. So on my blog up at the top, there's, you know, different buttons that you can click on. Of one of them is PDF store. And if you guys are bored at home wondering what can I do? Thank you, Debbie. Just efficient. Yeah, I try to be. Oh my gosh. Let me tell you, the email marketing day when I sit down to do those for the whole month, it's really not my favorite day. I really kind of dread it every month because I, you know, it's a lot of work, but I'm so glad to have it done and not have to think about it again after that. So, okay. So back to, if you guys are at home, you're bored, you're like, oh, what can I do? I do have PDFs for sale. All of my past to-go kits are still available, the tutorial only version. They're $15. You can see, so what I did was I put the pictures of each of the tutorials on there. If you click on the picture, or maybe it's the link below it, I can't even quite remember right now. Anyway, you can get to the YouTube video that showed the projects that we would make. And if you want the PDF tutorial, just send me a message and I'll send you a PayPal link to get that paid and I'll send it right out to you. So that's a great way. The tutorials, well, the class to go kits obviously are not available any longer, but the tutorials are still available. So it gives you step-by-step instructions on how to make all four of the projects we make on that class to go. So I give you product detail. So you get all of the like the colors, the dimensions, everything that you need to make those projects. And if you don't have everything that I'm using, you can just improvise and use what you have too. But anyway, so those are available. You know, like I said, if you're bored, they go back quite a few years too. So maybe you have an old stamp set or set of dies or something that you're like, oh, I would love to make something with this. Maybe I have a tutorial for it. So check those out on my blog again at gatheringinspiration.com. Okay. All right. I think I want to do a quick double check here. I'm sure I missed something, but I'm not even going to worry about it. It's good enough. Okay. So let's do our first drawing. Hey, Bonnie. Hello. Hello. We are going to draw for, what are we drawing for? The masks. These are the basic pattern decorative masks that literally look like nothing in this package, but I will tell you, there are trees in here, polka dots, what I called like a filigree pattern, and then I called another one a modern background. You can see them online, but they're super cool and fun to play with. You can sponge on them and make cool backgrounds on cards or even on fabric too. So, okay, that is what we're drawing for. Your name went into my little blue Stampin' Up! Trash bin if you shared the video, last week's video, or if you signed up for my email list. And like I always say, that's the best way, my email marketing is the best way to stay informed about what is going on around here. So, sign up for my email list if you haven't done that already. Yeah, okay, so we're shaking these around, making sure I've just got one in my hand. And the winner is Miss Becky White. Congratulations, Miss Becky. Beautiful. Thank you for sharing the video. So, Becky, I will get these masks sent out to you. So, congratulations. And thank you for the share, Diana. Okay. So, let's see. Actually, I need to dump those out and get ready for the other drawing that we will do in a little bit. Okay. there. Just trying to make sure I had all those in there. So this week, if you share the video or sign up for my email list, your name is going to go into the drawing to win this awesome bowl, this perfect springtime, right? The Rococo Rose there. No, I don't have the glare. You're welcome, Becky. This is the Rococo Rose. It's a scalloped, let me make sure I say it. Yep, scalloped linen ribbon. Beautiful, perfect for those springy, Eastery Mother's Day projects right now that you might be working on. So share the video, sign up for my email list, and you could win this ribbon that I will draw on next Friday's Facebook Live, okay? All right, so I want to, we had a number of new friends buy the starter kit, either through me or people in my downline, Hey Sunday, in our Inkspired Stampers group. So I want to give a warm welcome. I have a little bit of a list this week because you guys are like, okay, everybody's like, yeah, I really want to get that starter kit deal while I still can. So welcome to Miss Penny Cox, Roseanne Lafreniere, Tracy Claire, and my good friend Stacy Decker. This is a friend of mine that I've known since college. She just got the starter kit. And then as well, Miss Kelly Oldham. Kelly Oldham. Oldham, I guess is how I'm gonna say her name. And the fun part is when Kelly bought the starter kit through Diana, Diana actually promoted to silver. So she had enough in terms of sales to be considered silver, but she just needed her one recruit. And with Kelly signing up and getting the starter kit through Diana, she promoted to silver, which is awesome. Basically, she is gonna get it's a beautiful silver necklace that comes from Stampin' Up. And then for being a part of my Inkspired Stampers group, she is gonna get a $75 shopping spree for me. So congratulations, Miss Diana, you are knocking it out of the park. Let's see, what else? Oh, so then I had a couple of other people that have actually just bought the starter kit recently and they've already met their $300 quarterly minimum. So, or actually one person has. So Lori has met her $300 quarterly minimum, Lori Cresswell. Congratulations, Miss Lori. And then I have a couple of other people that are super duper close. So that's always really fun when somebody just gets the starter kit to kind of start out. Because basically, this is a great time to put your first order in after you get the starter kit because you can still take advantage of Sale-a-Bration. And we only have a few more days for that. So you still have time. If you're thinking about it, if you're on the fence, even stocking up on basics right now, you can still get free stuff. Stampin' Up, excuse me. Hey Tammy, hey Vina. All right, one sec. I need another sip of water. What I was starting to say was Stampin' Up! Did add some additional, even more items to the Sale-a-Bration offering that was back on Tuesday. I'm trying to remember, the things that I really remember were a couple different packs of designer series paper that are from the annual catalog, I think it is. I think it was pretty much all annual catalog product. But check it out. If you go to stampinup.com, click on shop, and then on the left-hand side, I think it's the very top tab, it says Sale-a-Bration. Just click on that, and then there's going to be one button that says free with a $50 order and one button that says free with a $100 order. So click on those, check them out, see if there's anything else you need. If there is, stock up on your basics, get your adhesive, get your cardstock, you know, whatever, envelopes, any of that basic stuff, right? And then you can still get free stuff too. And you're welcome, Miss Diana. All right, so yeah, know that that is out there and available to you. So don't forget then too, it's the last couple of days to get the starter kit. So in case you have any questions, we've been talking about it for months now, right? But I know people, sometimes you kind of hold out to the last minute trying to decide. So this is kind of like the last minute now, I would say. So this is the deal with that starter kit. You get to pick $125 in product, whatever you want. You also get to pick another free stamp set. Pick the most expensive, best stamp set that you don't already have and get that one for free. Plus you get that cute little mini paper trimmer and you get a sampler pack of designer series paper. You get all of that. Oh, plus there's a paper pumpkin kit. They always throw that in there too. And you get, what do you get? You get catalogs that you can give to your friends in case they ever want to order through you, right? You even get order forms so you could take an order, even though you're not going to be someone who sells Stampin' Up. Most people say that, I don't want to sell it, but why wouldn't you take an order from a friend? If somebody wanted to order something, why wouldn't you take it from them, right? It just helps you meet those quarterly minimums, right? And you get all of that. Yes, Jamie, it is an awesome, awesome deal, right? You get all of that for $99 plus sales tax in your state. In Michigan, that's $104.94. So we're 6% sales tax. So you got to figure out what your sales tax is. But basically, it's super cheap. For about $100, you are going to get, it's like close to $200, if not more than $200 value after you would add on tax and shipping on a big order like that. So anyway, truly, like Jamie says, she just took advantage of the deal very recently. It is an amazing deal. So why would you not want to do that, right? Plus then you get all the perks for being a demonstrator from Stampin' Up and for being a part of our awesome Inkspired Stampers group too. So if you have any questions, again, you know what? I'm going to give you my phone number one more time. If you have any questions on that starter kit deal, you can call or text me on that too. So again, my number is 989-330-0259. And I'd love to hear from you. As I'm realizing, you know, especially as everybody's kind of stuck at home, this is a great way for us to still connect, is even through texting and phone calling, like truly like talking with someone, right? So any questions, let me know, okay? Let's do our next drawing. So this is the drawing that if you put an online order in last week of at least $30, your name went in the drawing to win the well-dressed stamp set. And even if you participated in the buy one, get one free already, your name's in here too, you could win. Those people are also, like I said, gonna get the cards that I demonstrated on last Friday's Facebook Live if they put at least a $30 order in, right? If they bumped their order up to $50, they got to choose from either the Demo Design Dream Team PDF tutorial or the glitter enamel dots. That's with a $50 order, okay? So let's see, we are gonna shake this around. You guys wanna see, this is a super cute well-dressed stamp set. Okay, so lots and lots of good stuff. Sometimes, like, I can't even keep track of it all, you guys, it's ridiculous. Like, it's a lot of good stuff for an online order. And thank you, I have to say that as well, because things were kind of slow for pretty much the whole month of March. And then you guys started really kind of, I think, realizing, oh my gosh, Sale-a-Bration is ending. So thank you, every single one of you that put an order in. I truly appreciate your order. So thank you. It's funny how, because otherwise you feel a little bit like, not like I'm not doing this for anything, but it is nice to get paid, honestly, for what you're doing too. So thank you guys. Thank you so much. Okay, so here we go. All right, I'm shaking these all around. I've done that a lot, haven't I? Okay, and the winner is Miss Teresa Hinchman. So congratulations, Teresa. You are the proud winner of the well-dressed stamp set. So I will get that sent out to you along with the projects that we made last week. Okay, so do you guys want to see what we are going to give away? Sorry. Where is it? There we go. Okay. Well, I wish I could show you guys. The other thing I want to tell you to preface this, well, I'll show you. This is what we're going to give away on next week's Facebook Live. Very sweet. But congratulations, Susan. This is the Rise and Shine stamp set. So this is one of those Sale-a-Bration stamp sets. You can get it free right now with a $100 order. If you want to take your chances, though, I'm going to draw for this on next Friday's Facebook Live. So putting an online order in of at least $30 gets your name in the drawing to win the Rise and Shine. So super cute. It's the, like, the little coffee mug, tea mug stamp set. And they've got some fun sentiments in here, too, right? You've got this, but first you could say coffee with the cute little tag, right? There's a fun little Rise and Shine there. Let's hang out soon. X's and O's. There's a T, and then Make Today Amazing. I don't know if I'm showing that very well, but they're reversible too. So this is one stamp and it flips over because they're photopolymer. So you can use one side to stamp this way and one side to stamp that way. Same thing with those and those and those right there too. So super cute stamp set. What I was starting to say was, though, that we are seeing some delays in shipping from Stampin' Up. I'm going to give you an example. That stamp set, I thought for sure I would have it in my hands to be able to show you guys today. So in Michigan, it usually takes about a week between when I put an order in and when it comes to me. So I put my order in last Monday. Typically, I would get that shipment either this Monday or maybe even Tuesday. And I'm not getting it until Friday. It's not even here yet. I'm assuming, you know, the UPS man will be coming shortly while we're on Facebook Live, because that's how that will work, right? But anyway, that's my point, is that's an extra 3, maybe 4 days shipping time, which we all understand, you know, with everything that's going on, that's okay. But I just want you guys to kind of know that too. If you put an online order in, it's probably gonna take a little bit longer because they're not running the shipping and picking lines the way they normally are. They're trying to, the way I understood what Stampin' Up! Said, it's almost like they're, they stop for like an hour, so everybody that works like the first shift, then everything gets cleaned and sanitized, and then the next round of people come in for the next shift. So there's kind of like some downtime. I'm sure not quite as many people are there and that sort of thing too. So anyway, it is what it is. So just kind of know that it might take a little bit longer to get your order. And I'm seeing, actually, I already scrolled past there. Maybe Vina said it, but there are dies. They're called the Cup of Cheer dies that will cut these things out. Anything that's grayed out means that there was a die that will cut those things out too. And those dies were in the holiday catalog. They are still available. So if you were to get this free and you wanted to get the dies that go with them, just type in the little looking glass when you're shopping on StampinUp.com, just type in Cup of Cheer and it'll pop up, because they don't give us the number there. It's in a holiday catalog that I don't even have handy anymore, but super cute. So it went with the holiday stamp set, and now they are gonna work with the Rise and Shine Sale-a-Bration stamp set too. So, okay, gosh, I feel like I'm talking so much. Sorry, guys. This is like the last minute to make sure to tell you guys everything, I guess, is what's going on. Okay. Yeah, I think we're good. So let's see what else. Oh, I know. Well, no, we're going to talk about that. I'm going to show that in a sec, right? Okay, so I talked about most of it. The only other thing I want to mention is Sale-a-Bration Celebration. I've been posting on our Facebook group. I even emailed some people that were pretty close to earning their spot. So this is a fun event. Somebody asked me when I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it in May. It's funny because last year I did it in May and it actually worked out really well. In prior years, I'd done it in April, but I think I'm going to probably hold off, you know, because April is kind of questionable still about whether we can hold events or not. I'm hoping by May we should be like back in business, fingers crossed, right? But we will do this event live. As soon as I know, I will let you guys know. Or if you can't attend, I will make everything up and send it out to you. So this is the fun of the event, right? It's basically an awesome event where I spoil you. I say thank you for an awesome Sale-a-Bration, right? So I have little snacks and treats, which unfortunately I'm not able to mail those because I don't think they mail very well, right? I might throw some candy or something in there just for fun, right? But we'll have some specials. I'll even have my buy one, get one free stuff out there. We will be playing with new product also. That's the fun part and the reason why it's even better to wait until May, because by the network connection. All right, it's back on. Okay, good. That's the other thing I noticed with my group fitness classes. Things kind of blipped out quite a bit on her videos. I would be curious. I feel like that shows up maybe every few videos I get like a low connection thing, but so hopefully it's like continuous, because hers are definitely like it kind of blanks out for a sec. Sound goes away. So I don't know, maybe it depends on your internet provider too, or maybe it's just because everybody's on the internet and, you know, on Facebook now. I don't know. So okay, anyway, it's an awesome event. You're definitely going to want to come. You're going to want to be a part of it. And even if you're long distance, I promise you will feel loved from me as a thank you. I'll send everything to you, right? So these are the ways you earn your spot into Sale-a-Bration Celebration. You buy the starter kit. That's the best way, easiest way, right? Best deal too. If you hosted a private party or class, we're not able to do those anymore. But if anybody already has done that, they have earned their spot. And then the third way is to spend at least $200 with me through March 31. So the BOGO counts too, right? So if you're close, if you want to know where you're at, Sharon's saying it's your mouth and words that don't match. Somebody was saying that. It must be the live. That must happen. I haven't watched my videos back in a while, so I'm going to have to watch for that. Sometimes I wonder if it even isn't like somebody else's, like your connection, or I think you watch it on your TV, if that causes some kind of a delay too. But anyway, what I have noticed is when I watch at least the workout videos later, everything matches right up, and I have heard I have seen people make that comment on the live ones. So no, Sally, you can't buy the starter kit. You already did. You already got an awesome deal last Sale-a-Bration, I believe. So anyway, again, if you have any questions, if you want to know where you're at, if you want to know how close you are, send me a message, call, text, however you want to get a hold of me, and I can tell you how close you are, because I'd love to have I want to spoil as many people as I possibly can. So good. Okay, Diana's saying no delay on her phone. Yeah, it's probably just everybody's stuff right now too. It's all fairly overloaded, right? So, okay, are we ready? You guys are probably really ready for me to start stamping, aren't you? Oh, I just have to make sure. It's funny because, so I write these notes and then I have these arrows like, no, don't say that there, say that down there. And I'm like, when am I supposed to say these things? So, all right, I think I'm good. I think we are going to, we're gonna call it good. If I forgot anything, I'll post about it on our group. So, okay. Let's see, I had some stuff I was gonna show you and now I wanna show you some different stuff first. So hold on, I gotta get this a little bit organized before I flip the camera down. Okay, hold on. Oh, Sally, spoil me. Sure, I would love to spoil you, Miss Sally. And Sharon has fixed it. Awesome. So whatever the trouble, the tea rubble was, right? That's good. I'm glad to know that you were able to fix that. Okay, so I'm just getting this a little bit organized because you guys, well, no, I'm not even going to say it yet. Hold on. Let's get this all set out here. Okay, I think it's good. All right, we're going to flip the camera down. Woohoo, right? turn your heads away. I'm flipping the camera down and we'll be back in un momento, I should say, right? Uno momento. I don't know. Okay, let's see. All right. Ooh, glare, that's right. The sun is shining now, ladies. Yay. Okay, we're not really going to complain about that, but let's see. Oh my. It's just going to be the way, isn't it? Okay, well, it's a beautiful Friday here in Michigan. Yesterday was fairly gloomy, although not rainy. They said it was going to be rainy, so that would be even worse. So, okay, make sure I have my info straight here. This is the Tropical Oasis class to go. So a perfect example, those PDF tutorials that I was talking about. Those, you know, the class to go kit's not available any longer, but if you want to know how to make all of these cards or... Sally, flip it real. Okay, I gotcha. Like a whippet. Okay, sorry, you're like making me LOL out loud for real. Okay, back to what I was saying. Tropical Oasis class to go right here. Today is the last day to RSVP. So I want to make sure, because I don't think I've gone through all of the details yet. I want to make sure that you know. You will get parts and pieces to make two of each of these cards. I'll show you the cards super quick. Fun, beautiful, gorgeous. I keep saying I'm bringing spring break to you since we can't even go on spring break anymore, right? Okay, so you get to make two of each of those cards. I give you all the parts and pieces. If you already have the stamp set and the dies, you're going to want to pick option number one. You're going to get a quarter of a pack of the Tropical Oasis paper. So it's actually each of these cut in half. You're going to get a 6x12 piece of each of these beautiful, gorgeous, floral, tropical patterns of paper. You're also going to get a package of the Tropical Oasis trinkets, awesome trinkets. You are also going to get a full bolt of the, what is this even called? The braided burlap trim. This is that fun trim that I've shown you guys how you can like pull it apart so much, right? So option number one is $40. Now, again, that's if you already have the stamp set and dies. So only get option number one if you already have these. If you don't have these, you are going to want to pick option number two. And it's just another $44, which this costs actually more than $44 just for the stamp set and dies. So it's an awesome, it's a steal, basically, ladies. So for $84, you get the stamp set, you get the dies, you get the trinkets, you get a quarter of a pack of the paper, you get the burlap trim, and you get all the parts and pieces to make two of each of these projects. So eight
cards total. Plus, you get a free celebration item, and you are actually getting the trinkets for free with option number two. So it's a fabulous deal. Option number one and two, you can either pick them up locally, or shipping is an additional $8 to get it shipped to you if you're not local to me, right? Then let's see what else. Option number three is if you just want the tutorial. You already have everything that you need to make these. You just want to know dimensions, colors, all that good stuff, products that I used. You get the PDF tutorial. It's just $15. That's always available. And all of my past PDF tutorials are still available on my blog at gatheringinspiration.com. Option number four is anybody that's in my Inkspired Stampers. It's another fabulous reason to become an Inkspired Stamper, because you can get the PDF tutorial for free always, or you can get the make and takes, two of each of these cards. You're going to want to have your own stamp set and dies, because I can never do my, I can't do stamping for you guys, right? But you get the make and take, all the parts and pieces. So I give you the ribbon that you need, the trinkets that you need, the paper that you need. Everything's cut and ready to go. You just do your stamping and die cutting. That is $12 for the 8 cards. Basically, it's an awesome, awesome deal. So if you guys have any questions, today is actually the last day to RSVP. So send me a message, send me a text, email me, let me know if you have any questions. I'd love to get one of these kits set up and send out to you. And I will bring spring break to you, since we can't have our spring break like we thought we were going to, right? I am a little bit sad about that. Monday, we would have been getting on a cruise ship. And the funny thing is, my sister and I, not that long ago, were like, oh, we'll be fine. We can still go on that trip. Well, then Royal Caribbean said, I don't think so. We're canceling the cruises, which is good. We didn't quite realize how, you know, it was before it was quite as crazy as it is around here. So anyway, no cruise ship for us this year. Okay. So, or my family, actually. Yeah, everyone's disappointed and all that, right? Okay, so what do I want to show you guys? Couple of other, so product of the week. Ooh, I'm going to put my glasses on since you guys can't see me now, because I don't need them to see. I only need them to see up close, so I have to put them on the end of my nose, and my kids always make fun of me, so I don't want you guys to see me looking like that either. So this is our product of the week, the Timeless Tulips Bundle, the stamp set, and the punch. So I have to show you guys some other beautiful cards made with this bundle. So this is actually, I shared this one on our group the other day. This is a cute little card inspired by my friend Melissa Roberts that I just did our weekend retreat with. She made a card similar to this, and I thought it was so cute. So we actually made this card at our Simple Beautiful card class this month. Then this is a fun swap card, another card. I posted all of these on our Facebook group, so maybe they look familiar, but I love the little polka dot pattern, and I love the scallops, right? So this is the square, scallop square dies, and then this is the new one with the stitching, stitched so sweetly with the scallop and the stitch, both, right? So over on the square dies, they just have either straight edge or scallop edge, and now stitched so sweetly has both the scallop and the stitching. And this was a swap that I received from Lynn Strefert way back at the beginning of the year. And then another here, this is my favorite, because there's a lot going on here, right, with her layers. But again, she used that same die there also. Yes, you're welcome for the videos and the cards. And I agree, Philomena, these are beautiful. I almost was like, oh, maybe we'll just make this one on Facebook Live because it's so pretty. I love, love, love all of the Parisian embossing folder. I think that's some of the Parisian Designer Series paper now too. I couldn't think of what it was before. Some of the beautiful champagne rhinestones. And this is a swap from Susan Levasseur, I'm going to say. She is at wownolacreations.com. So beautiful, beautiful card. So if you're not sure what you think of the Timeless Tulips Bundle, I think once you see some of these projects, you might think you just have to have it too, right? Okay, another quick sip of water. And actually one more that I'm going to show you guys too. So this is a card that I designed for, you want to know how to make it, if you get the Demo Design Dream Team PDF tutorial, there it is right there. Actually, I was just going to kind of flip. So these are, some of them, You can kind of see, and maybe some of them not quite as well. Anyway, this is the full tutorial for March. If you put your online order in of at least $50 in the BOGO sale, you automatically get the tutorial for free, and you can learn exactly how I made this fun card right here. The Happy Easter, Happy Spring, Happy, Happy Everything, and then with the fun tulip builder punch as well there. Okay? All right. We are going to make some cards. You guys ready to do that? I'm moving everything but the grid paper. That's what I'm looking for, is my grid paper. Okay. Yeah, and checking my notes to make sure I have everything. Oh, here's the host code too, ladies. The 4P442Y2V. That's the code that you're going to want to use. Put your online order in, shop from the BOGO sale, and you get all the fabulousness. I'll show you one more time what all that fabulousness is after we make our projects here. So, okay, the first one, let's see, I'm like, which one should we do first? So I finally got to use, you guys, I haven't been very good about using the new Sale-a-Bration items, but this is some of the new vellum. What is that even called? We didn't have very long to play with it, so I kind of got, Well, it's the vellum from Sale-a-Bration. I thought I had the brochure out here, but I don't. Probably gave it away to somebody. So anyway, this is the vellum. This is Purple Posy. You can see I'm using Purple Posy cardstock, which I haven't used in a while, and it's a perfect, beautiful spring color, right? It also comes in what's the foam? The seaside foam, whatever. That really pale green. I'm totally drawing a blank. And Pool Party, I think, is the blue one. So beautiful. And it's got, can you guys see the kind of texture on the vellum? Very fun, right? Okay, so, and we used our Get Well Soon from our Timeless Tulip stamp set. Okay, so let me just break on out here. Yep, okay, we're good. So make sure I have what we need, because I used some of these stamps on both of the cards too. So I was trying to make sure that I have everything that I need here. Okay. All right. So these are all the parts and pieces. So, okay. Lots of white. Here's the vellum again. So you can kind of see that it is really see-through-y. Yes, thank you, Anna, so very vellum. Thank you. You guys are always so helpful, and I do truly appreciate that. Okay, so here is our piece of Purple Posy cardstock. We cut it in half along the 11-inch side at 5.5, and then along the 8.5-inch side, we scored it at 4.25 inches. They get better and better. Thank you, Philomena. You're so sweet. Okay, then the vellum, this is my standard layering. This one measures 4 inches by 5.25 inches, and that's just going to go right on top of there, right? Then we just have scraps of paper to do our stamping and die cutting and so on. Okay, so we're gonna die cut this piece and then we're gonna stamp on it because I wanna make sure that everything fits. Usually I say stamp and then die cut. This is the one time that we're gonna do it backwards. Okay, so let me grab die cutting machine. We're gonna just scoot those up there too, okay. I want the handle on this side though. Okay. All right, so we got this. All right, so these are kind of, I'm not gonna say an oldie but a goodie, but they have been around for a little while. The stitched labels dies, can you see? I love all of these dies. I haven't figured out what to do with that yet, but everything else I've used a ton of times because it's got the stitching, it's got the scallop. Oh, these are gorgeous also. Lots and lots of detail on these. So we're gonna use this baby right here. I'm gonna just put that right on there. And sorry if it wiggles. Turn your head away for a sec. That's super wiggly, isn't it? Okay, let's see how. You know what? Actually, we're gonna do this too. Let's scoot this out of the way because I think I'm gonna need it again later. So we are gonna use this little baby. It's gonna help us kind of get all the parts and pieces out of here that we need. So that kind of helped release a lot of those. Now, and you want to be kind of gentle, because if you push really hard, that's kind of, the detail is kind of delicate, right? So don't push too hard or you might rip something. But isn't that, I love that piece. Thank you for sharing, Rosemary. Okay, so we got that. So now we are going to do our stamping. And I'm going to grab my extra grid paper so I can stamp on here and not get anything. Where's my card? Okay, so we're going to make sure. So with the big, no, we're not going to do the big one. We're going to do the little. So there's kind of here, check this out. Small, medium, large tulip, right? Small, medium, large. That's what we're going to do. So we're going to do small, medium right on here. And then the large, we're going to stamp separately and punch it out. And we're going to use So Saffron ink. This is the perfect pale yellow ink for our springtime projects. Let's move that over there. Okay, so we're gonna put him right there, and then we're gonna put that one right there. All right, now we're gonna scoot this out of the way just for a sec. We are gonna stamp, and I wanna show you a trick, because somebody asked me not too long ago, how do you know, where to stamp so that you punch properly? So I think if you turn it over, that is the first step to knowing where to punch. So can you see? If you stamped this, if you stamped that tulip on that end, then you would have to put this paper in here and you'd end up punching this piece that you don't need. But if you punch down at this end, you can get just what you need, right? So you want to kind of be strategic and look how you're going to put your paper in to not waste paper. If you don't care about wasting paper, then don't worry about it. But I kind of like to be a little bit conservative. So we are going to stamp right over here, okay? And then this is just gonna pop right in there. And then I've got very little waste. Whereas, like I said, if I would have punched or stamped down at the other end, I would have wasted more paper. Oops, there, do that. You get a little bit of waste, but not much. Okay, scoot that out of the way. There's like a little something on my ink pad. You know, it's kind of bugging me. All right, where are we at? Now, actually, we've got to come back and stamp right on here. Again, we're going to stamp our stems and our leaves, okay? Thank you, Becky. I'm glad you like these cards. All right, so I did the stems first. This is, what color is this? Pear Pizzazz. So we're going to use Pear Pizzazz, and we are going to kind of go that one right there. We're gonna do that one right there. And then right through the middle, you're gonna imagine that we're gonna put our big tulip in there too. Okay, so we've got that. Now we are gonna stamp some leaves. Okay, so we're gonna do one there. We're gonna do one there. And then I thought it was kind of good to just put one kind of layer right in there too. Okay, so very, very pretty. Oops, and then I put my other ink back and I still need to stamp. So on these are actually precise measurements. Ah, your favorite color, this really soft pale yellow, right? The So Saffron. So this little strip measures 1/2 inch by 3 7/8 inches. And this is what we're gonna stamp our Get Well Soon on. So we're gonna grab that and, okay, you guys can still see. I have to be able to see it too, and the camera's in my way. And if I don't like it, you know, it's not too bad. We're gonna flip it over and see. Let's try it on this side too. Maybe it was a little bit low. I might've done that one low too. There, that's better. Okay. Here, we're good now. All right, so we are going to, there, I had a backup one just in case. So I had 4 chances to get it right. Scissors right here. I got my adhesive too. Well, I'm thinking about it. Okay, so for the end of this, I like to just find what I think is about the middle, snip up in the center just a little bit, then go to one corner and cut up at an angle, flip it over, and again, one corner, cut up at an angle. And there we go. All right, now I think we are ready to put things together. So what I like to show you guys is if that's going to go, let's move these things out of the way. We'll clean those in a moment. So I don't like to see my adhesive in the corners. Typically, I would put adhesive here and here and here and here, but I don't want to see adhesive. So I'm trying to kind of look and figure out where this is going to go and then put adhesive. Actually, maybe if I, you know what we can do? How about this, ladies? Let's actually put it on. Okay. So we're going to add a bunch of adhesive on this piece. Here, let's get rid of, we don't need that now, do we? Too many things distracting here, right? Okay, so we're gonna put that right there, right? And then actually, let's put our Get Well Soon on, because then this, it'll all make sense in a second. I'm not verbalizing very well, I'm realizing. But we're gonna put all of these things on here first, so that then we know where we can put our adhesive. And I'm going to press really firmly because I don't want those things to pop up off of there. Now we know where we can put adhesive here to help our vellum stay on our card base without seeing any of the adhesive. Ha ha, how about that, ladies, huh? Okay, so again, I'm gonna press super firmly, and this is stiff enough that it might pop up a little bit, but it really didn't bother me if the edges weren't tacked down. Now we need some dimensionals. We're gonna add a couple dimensionals behind our little tulip, not little, this is our big, this is our large tulip, right? And we're gonna put him maybe right about there, okay? So we're gonna peel the backs off of our dimensionals and we're gonna put that right there. Okay, one more, actually two more. You know, I always have to add a little something fun. So we're gonna use some Whisper White Baker's Twine. It's the perfect little accent. Not too much, just adds a little something to our project, okay? So we are going to, yeah, the flowers. Diana saying yellow is my favorite color of flowers. I love all flowers, all colors. They're all gorgeous, aren't they? But yes, yellow is very pretty too. Okay, so this is my trick. I just put a tiny bit of adhesive and then I kind of like to kind of almost like roll it up in a little bit of a line, if you will. Because for this baker's twine, it's so thin, I think a glue dot is too much. So, and that kind of helps keep your bow nice on there also, okay? Last step is to just sprinkle a few pearls on your cards. So we're gonna put one there, we're gonna do one there, and maybe one down there. Okay, and I'm gonna press firmly, make sure those stay on there. And there we go. So we have our super cute little Get Well Soon card. Isn't that beautiful? I love that soft, the purple and yellow too. Purple, yellow, green, great springtime color combination, right? Okay, so let's scoot these guys off out of the way. I'm gonna clean these stamps because now that I, you know, once you're on Facebook Live, you kind of lose your brain. And I know I need some of these stamps again, and I can't quite remember which ones. So we're gonna, I love this. So when I use my scrub pad and my mist, I'll scrub it on the wet side, dry it on the dry side, and then there's always still a shadow. When I use this thing, I don't know where it goes, but there's no shadow. So I still do that just because it's like a habit that I can't seem to break. And you guys can see how beautiful my chamois is too, right? Yeah, I did actually just wash it. Well, I ran it through, you know, water. I let water run over it on my sink, in my sink, basically. And I do, you can squeeze it, wring it out, get a bunch of the color out of it. There we go. Okay, so a little lesson in how to clean your stamps. Oh, thank you, Philomena. A lovely Get Well, she says. Thank you, thank you. I agree. And we can always use those cards, right? Yes, and you could make that a birthday card too, right? Like gorgeous, Vina saying it's gorgeous, so very cheerful and springy. So it could be a birthday card or something else too. So, all right, my next one, I think we're good, is inspired by, I'll show you. So at the very back of the catalog, yeah, you could use a thinking, especially right now. Yes, Very good idea, Miss Nancy. You could put that on there instead too. Yeah. Okay, so this is the very back of the spring mini catalog, which I don't know if people ever really get back to the very back of the catalog. I believe the idea with Stampin' Up! Was to show how you could use stamps for kind of more than one type of project. So they showed a card. These are kind of like little 3D, because I think that's actually the little mini pizza box. And then this is maybe like a little scrapbook page. So they wanted to show how versatile the stamping was. And what I loved was this color combination, the really kind of deep purple. I thought this was probably Blackberry Bliss. And hey, Abby, how are you? And then I went with balmy blue. Let me look. Yeah, balmy blue. I think bashful blue was an old one. So anyway, but I loved how these looked, and that's kind of how I came up with, you can see my stamping on here was similar to what they did there, right? So another great way to use your resources too, if you're like, I don't know what to do, check out the catalogs. It can be a really good jumping off point for you to kind of start making your projects. So actually these were, they inspired both of my cards, that idea on the first card. And then the next one I went more with like the color scheme that they used on here. I loved, I don't know if you're getting that very well, but it's on page 67 in your spring mini catalog. Let me show you. The suspense is probably killing you, right? So this is the card that I designed that uses, again, balmy blue card base, and then this is drawing a total blank now, Blackberry Bliss. Yeah, with some more So Saffron, and then this one I used Old Olive with a double bow. So we did a single baker's twine bow on the other one. We're going to do a double bow on this one, ladies. Super intense, right? Okay, so let's see. And actually, I will tell you that my friend Melissa, that I did the crafting retreat with, this is a very similar style. I kind of cased, she was making a bunch of cards with this Timeless Tulip stamp set. So I took pictures of everything that she made. And this was a good, I kind of cased the layout of her card. Different colors, if I remember correctly, but same kind of idea. Okay, so we need, not to be confused, I don't need that stem and I don't need that baby anymore. Or let's see, what is that one? Get well. We don't need the get well. Okay, so we're gonna use, oops, not that leaf either. Sorry, let me make sure. Okay, so yeah, so I've got the big flower, the medium, the stem, the leaf, the hello, and then I got a special surprise on the inside I'm gonna show you guys in a minute. Okay, so scoot that all out of the way. Here we go. Yeah, do we have, okay, we're gonna get parts and pieces out now. Okay, so this time, starting with a balmy blue card base, again, simple. We didn't do flippy fun folds today, but I love them, right? We'll have to break one of those out again. Okay, so 8.5 by 11, along the 11 inside, cut it in half at 5.5 inches, along the 8.5 inside, score it at 4.25 inches. Oh yes, in a little mini frame, like a wall picture, you're right. It would be, wouldn't it? Yes, it would, Vina. Okay, so then we have, this is the white piece. I don't know why I'm being so funny, but this is the white piece that's going to go in the inside that I'll show you in a few minutes, that measures the 4 inches by 5.25 inches. And this is what I was saying. These are all the things. I'll give you the colors, the dimensions, item codes for everything that we use will be on my blog this afternoon at gatheringinkspiration.com. This one is also Blackberry Bliss, 4 by 5.25. So if you're not writing it down now, you can check back this afternoon and get the info that you need. Okay, so this one, again, we are gonna die cut this piece and then do our stamping. Very unusual that we're doing that twice. Oh, and actually, can you see? This piece is embossed with the Scripty 3D embossing folder. So let's do that. I've got so much out here. Let's see if we can actually make room. Yeah, here, we need this piece. And okay, yeah. All right, so let's do our die cutting first since it's set up. Right now it's set up to do the die cutting. Okay, and we used the stitched So Sweetly dies. This is the largest one in this pack, right? So we use that guy right there, the largest scallop stitched rectangle that we have. So you just need a piece of Whisper White cardstock that's big enough to put that on, okay? All right, sorry, it might be wiggly again. I'm realizing I've been really chatty, so. But you know what? What else do most of us have to do these days, right? Okay, so there's that, right? Beautiful, the stitching, the scallops, he's so cute. All right, put that in there. Now, I don't think I need any of these things. We are gonna grab my regular platform. And then since this is a 3D embossing folder, we need our blue embossing folder plate. And the scripty 3D embossing folder that I almost couldn't find for a sec. So you just wanna make sure you have the words going the right way. So since this is a tall card, we wanna make sure they're going that way, right? Okay, we're gonna put that on there, our blue plate on top. If you don't have the blue plate, don't use two of your clear plates because it's too thick. You just have to shim like with some copy paper or some cardboard or something. But I would recommend getting that. I'm sure we're going to need it when the new die cutting and embossing machine comes out. I believe that is supposed to be coming out with the next annual catalog. Or at least will be available at some point. I'm pretty sure it's in the new annual catalog. That's what I thought they said anyway. Don't quote me on it. I haven't seen the new annual catalog yet. Okay, so let's see. Let's do some stamping now. So we have our cute little scallop piece here. I'm actually going to put that back underneath there. Yeah, so we're going to use, this is Old Olive. No, you know what? We're not going to do that yet. Let's do, sorry, I was trying to remember how I did this one. So we're going to stamp our big tulip in Blackberry Bliss ink. Okay, so we're going to stamp that on the edge. I left that there to remind myself which end to stamp. Okay, so we're going to do our Blackberry Bliss. So you can see there's going to be, these builder punches always give you, you know, it gets a little messy on the table, but we've got that one. Next, we are going to, did I bring enough? Oh, that's right. I fussy cut, ha! I forgot about that. Okay, so we're gonna do a leaf there and a leaf there. And then, oh, cause I wanted to show you guys. So I've been doing more fussy cutting lately with the my paper snips. Okay, so we're gonna just stamp this right on here cause it's really so easy. So again, this was our So Saffron ink and kind of the medium punch. I'm gonna just cut these off cause I don't want to accidentally punch through. So these, you can see I punched my leaf over on this side, right? This is almost like that's on the end, right? Because then you don't waste a bunch of cardstock. If you'd done it the other way, you'd be punching over one of the leaves to punch the other one out, and that would be not good. You'd have to separate them further. You'll learn too, if I'm not making sense, go to stamp it and punch it, and you'll know exactly what I mean when you go to do that. Okay, so we're gonna put those there. So now, let's just get rid of this stuff. Because I want you guys to see how easy, with your paper snips, if you don't have paper snips, you have to get a pair of the paper snips. Because what I'm finding is it's almost like I'm kind of cutting, but I'm kind of turning the paper with me, like as I'm making the cut. So it's kind of working together, okay? So we're gonna just kind of cut inside here, and then I turn it, and I cut back, and I cut inside there, and I turn it, and I might kind of wiggle the paper a little bit where it looks more like it just should wiggle. And you can see, I mean, it just doesn't have to be precise. And I might even cut in a little bit, but that's okay. Then I can just bring it back out. And it's beautiful, isn't it, right? Okay, so what I wanted to do, the whole point of part of this, was I wasn't sure to put my where to put my stems. So I'm gonna put my dimensionals on my flowers here, and then I'm gonna bring this piece back in and kind of put those on there, lay them about where I think I want them, and then I'm gonna grab my Old Olive ink again. And this is gonna kind of help me line up where. So maybe move that, put that one there. And it doesn't matter if you can't see the top of it, right? and maybe that one right there. That should be good. Okay. And then actually these guys, oops. Yeah, so these little bits go everywhere when you use a builder punch. Those are both punched out, so we're just gonna put some dimensionals behind those too. The other thing we need to do is stamp our little hello in our balmy blue ink. So just kind of down in the corner, we're gonna say hello. All right, good there. And then where are those leaves? Oh, good. They're both right here. I thought I only had one. I was like, oh, that's not good. I'm going to use the mini dimensionals. These are handy for these little bit skinnier kind of things, right? Put those on there. Okay. So we're going to just peel these off. We are going to put one tulip right there. Aren't these just gorgeous? Put another one maybe right there. And then we are gonna add our leaves, right? Okay, so which way? I think that looks like the better way. So we're gonna put one there, and then it's gonna be opposite, right? I guess it didn't really matter. You could go either way. So then this one, yeah, maybe right about there, right? Then, okay, double bow, ladies. Double baker's twine bow. This is super high tech. So just put this like two strands together and then work like it's one strand of twine. Probably the hardest part is getting this little bit, two strands through that little hole there. It's really not that hard, but that's maybe the futziest part about it. And then we're just gonna kinda get those where we like them. Should I like to use my ribbon scissors that I don't think are even available anymore, but I will not ever give those babies up. Now this one is thick enough, I would use a mini glue dot on, okay? It's just that single knot. There's like not enough, the glue dot just kind of sticks out too much or something there. Okay, so we got that on there. Ooh, crafter math, seriously, ladies. All right, so now we are gonna kind of build the outside. We still have to do a little bit on the inside of our card. Now you can see I like to use a good amount of adhesive on, where's my card base? On this piece because it's embossed, okay? So we've got this one right there, and then we're gonna add some more adhesive. This one I'm gonna use quite a bit on as well because there's a lot going on that piece, right? How cute though, right? Love that deep purple too with the lighter, like the pale blue. Okay, so now for the reveal of the inside, I did hello, happy Mother's Day. So we put a couple more of the little, the smaller, if you will, tulips. So let's see, we've got our balmy blue. So, or it could be hello, happy birthday, or hello, thinking of you. But, you know, Mother's Day will be here before we know it, right? So I did a happy Mother's Day. Plus, I think, look at how cute that font is on there, isn't it? Like, oh my gosh, some woman with beautiful cursive handwriting. That looked really fuzzy, didn't it? All of our craft rooms are a mess, yes, because we're all stuck at home crafting, exactly. What an awful thing for us to have to do all the time, ladies, huh? Okay, so one tulip there, we're gonna do one there, and then I just couldn't stop, so I put one down there too. There we go. All right, so now we can add this to the inside of our card. Yeah, so if you guys have made anything lately, I keep asking that. I would love, 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 love to see what you guys have made lately. So just take a picture and upload it to our Facebook group right here where we're watching right now, or if you're watching later, anytime, we would love to see what everybody is up to, because I know we are all having a lot of fun in our craft rooms right now, because why not, right, ladies? So what do you guys think? You love these? Which one do I like better? I think I like that one better. Yeah. Love these tulip cards, huh? Yeah, and yours is messy too. I hear you, Sharon. Why not have some fun in there? So, okay, quick recap. Don't forget about the buy one, get one free sale. Shop online, find the yellow striped, it's actually kind of so saffron color, yellow striped banner that says BOGO sale. I'm gonna keep posting, so hopefully it'll be at the top of our Facebook group, right? Hop on there on the discussion tab, just type your name in below any item that you want. Then I can help you figure out the total dollar value. Go online to stampinup.com, shop, and when you check out, use that host code right there, the 4P442Y2V. It is on the banner that I have for the BOGO sale, and it's always on my blog at gatheringinspiration.com, okay? When you put at least a $30 order in, you're gonna get your BOGO stuff, right? You're gonna get both of these cards, either the make and takes or full cards put together, you choose. You are also going to get your name in the drawing. That's why I couldn't find this before, right? Because I had it open. To the Rise and Shine stamp set, you're going to get your name in the drawing for this next week, right? And then you are also going to get the Demo Design Dream Team PDF tutorial sent to you. Is that it? I'm trying to think. Yep. BOGO. Oh, Sale-a-Bration too. So take advantage. You get BOGO, you get cards, you get Sale-a-Bration stuff, you get PDF tutorials. Yes, it is an awesome, awesome time to shop. So this is your last chance, right? Between now and midnight on Tuesday night. So we have Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. We have 5 days left to take advantage of Sale-a-Bration. Then it's all done. And then those people that are brand new that started during Sale-a-Bration are going to be like, what do I get for free with my $50 order in April? And you're going to say, nothing, unless you want to, you know, give them a thank you, right? But anyway, it's going to end. It's going to come to an end and we're going to be so sad. So you guys, thank you so much. Oh, you're so sweet, Vina. I'm glad I can lift your spirits. Oh, sorry. Here I am like shaking my shirt out. So, hey, Linda, oh my gosh. Let's see. Oh, yes. Oh, good. Diana, you're answering a question that I totally missed. I would come back and see it later. I promise, guys. So thank you. I know, and I'm going to say that too. I know I missed a bunch of comments because you guys are all super chatty, which I totally love. But then, like I said, I've already gone, oh my gosh, almost an hour and a half as it is. So I'm glad I didn't get myself any more distracted than I already was. So you guys just hang in there. I know it's just kind of tough, scary times. Hopefully all of you guys are healthy and safe. I think that's the best thing we can do is just keep it that way. I know it gets kind of frustrating, but you know, we'll look back on this, right? And go, shoo, okay, I'm glad we did what we needed to do to stay safe and healthy. And it will be over. At some point it will be over and we'll all be able to get back out and enjoy things. So thank you guys so much for watching. Again, don't forget, Sale-a-Bration ends on Tuesday at midnight. So don't miss out. And oh, one more time, my phone number, if you need to call or text me, 989-330-0259. I would be happy to help you while we're all just chilling at home. Okay, be safe, everybody, and we'll see you next Friday. Bye.